Scott from Atlas Forest News down here at the Gorge Waterway interviewing MS Warriors on their way to world domination in dragon boat racing.
It's a river under uncertain skies. I walk and I wonder all the hows and the whys. And I try to remember why I started this way. How much farther I have to go in the cold light of day. Sometimes I'm lost.
This is my first year.
How are you enjoying it?
I like it a lot, and the people are great.
It's nice to get out on the water.
It is. Any water sport, I think, would be good for everyone.
All right, Warriors, everybody ready? Push off, please. Nice and easy, paddles up. Take it away.
I've been blessed, absolutely blessed with the opportunity of coaching these great, great people. They inspire me, they inspire people around them, they inspire themselves. And so like I say, every opportunity that I get a chance to get in that boat and coach them is a great day. So there are times when I'm feeling, well, I'm just not feeling good. I'm feeling tired, like you say, or I've got a bit of an owie, I've got a bit of a something. And I come down here and I realize that whatever I have coming down to the dock is nothing, absolutely nothing, compared to these people that I know are just so exhausted. To get out of bed is a struggle for them, and I know it's a struggle for them to get down to the boat. But the moment that they're here, like I say, they inspire themselves as individuals, they inspire people around them, that all of a sudden they get this energy. And so for the next hour and a half, I will run them ragged out there. And they're excited. You know, they're exhausted, but they got smiles on their faces.
How do I discover all I see?
My neurologist told me about the dragon boat team that the MS Society had, and I was very excited about it. Because I weight train every week, and I like to stay in shape just to keep the muscles working. And dragon boating, it just took on a whole new area for me, because the muscles that I use dragon boating are different than the muscles that I use even wheelchair. A lot of arm movements wheelchairing, but they're different muscles when you, it involves core more, which I don't get to use wheelchair. So, and I think it's helping with my stability. I don't have a lot of balance because my stabilizers aren't coordinating properly, but I think the dragon boating is helping that definitely. I was here a very short time, and they all made me feel so part of the group. You know, we get out there and it's just so beautiful being out on the water and knowing that you're with a group of people that are sharing the same things that you are.
I started dragon boating in 2007 when the head physiotherapist at the MS Society, where I go to on North Park in Vancouver, started a dragon boat team. So I have been hooked since day one. And like through it all, my body has transformed and my life's transformed and my mental state's transformed and everything in my life. Everything is so amazing, all because of the sport. I know that I'm hooked for life now on it. We've gone from people being like, yay, MS, like people feeling sorry or like putting up with us, to being like, holy crap, MS, look at you guys go. We're known now as a competitive team. So it's like, I've seen the procession, and that progression has happened for me personally too, as well as the team. Like, I've seen it all happen. It's amazing. So basically, through the love of the sport and Chinese medicine, I'm going to be walking very soon. I mean, I walk every day, but back to normal walking. To me, that's walking. None of this, you know, shuffling about. But anyway, so that's, to me, that's like the best feeling in the world. It's nice because it feels like we're part of something way bigger than just dragon boating.